So microfluidics is basically this new emerging research area that targets design automation, automating the process of moving fluids on devices for biochemical applications.
Yeah, and I developed an HRI, human robot interaction graduate course on usability testing on a cobot called Baxter. So this study will present the design, implementation, and results of this project. It's like we already had a Baxter, we just had to like see how we can use it to teach for the purpose of teaching the theory and the methods of usability testing.
Quantifying gerrymandering. So how do we detect gerrymandering here in North Carolina in a mathematically rigorous way? You can have a district that's 60% blue and 40% red, and you get an outcome where blue wins or you get an outcome where red wins based on how you draw the maps. So how you draw the maps is absolutely essential to the actual outcome that we're producing, right? So there's 13 to the 300 possible redistrictings of North Carolina. For context, there's 10 to the 80 atoms in the universe. So there are just a vast number, an intractable number of maps to look at, right? So how do we look through that haystack and find all the needles in a representative way?
In this work, we are considering the notion of proportionality in several different scenarios. The first scenario is about proportionally fair clustering. So in the second scenario, we try to consider the proportional chore allocation.
It's all part of a vast connections project called Data and Technology for Fact Checking. It's led by Jun Yang and Bill Adair. Bill Adair actually co-founded PolitiFact, I believe, and so both people that are very interested in the whole space of trying to use technology for political good. Archana and I both study computer science and political science, and so thinking about how we can use tech to improve civic outcomes is definitely something that's really relevant to both of our interests. So we saw this Vast Connections project, we're like, this sounds pretty meaningful.